Hi there, I'm Tyler with TimefireVR. This is the second part in a three-part series covering a low and high poly workflow. The first part covered the king, low, and high, and part of the knight's high poly. The second will be finishing up the knight, and the third will cover the knight's low poly. I'm going to start this part off with the hair. I use a plane, but somewhat quickly decide to just work with a single edge and extrude the verts in a side orthographic view. This tends to be a nice simple start for me, especially when something is going to be mirrored. I don't have a reference or concept for the hair as much as I did the head, so there's some experimentation going on with different sizes and general styles. I want to make sure it's simple to go with what I have for the head already and the rest of the set. I'm adding in the subsurface modifier now so I can work with smoother lines to really dial in the profile that I want. It's important to note that I'm very slowly adding in additional verts. I'm not totally solid on the design for the hair, so having as few polys as possible will allow me to make large, sweeping edits without having to maintain verts that aren't impacting the overall shape. Referring back to part one, I'm working with the large forms first and saving the details for later. I'm running dry on inspiration for the hair, so I move back to the head. I'm doing some small maintenance, things I will need to hit eventually before completing, like connecting the mirror seam and shoring up some of the larger forms. In a moment, you'll notice I struggle a little with a bevel. If you ever run into a problem like this of verts or segments not behaving the way you expect, be sure to check for double verts and apply the rotation and scale. In this instance, it was the rotation and scale, which can be applied by hitting Ctrl A while a mesh is selected in object mode. I've gone back to the head now, adding in some control loops to sharpen a few edges. I'm checking the changes against the opposite side that isn't showing any wireframes. Not only can I view without the wires obstructing details, but it also gives me a chance to orbit and check multiple angles, which is one of the most important things to do in 3D development. Now I'm starting on the ears. Even though it's part of the head that now has some detail polish, I'm still going to hit the larger shapes first and then work my way in. Working this way can make complex shapes and folds a lot less intimidating and get you the goal result much quicker. Thank you. As I build the shape of the ear up, I'm trying to work with what I have as best I can, then add in edge loops when I know I can't go any further. Then repeat for another layer of detail. I find I can keep geometry cleaner and I have to fight less to get the shapes I want if I'm always trying to build up in this way. Oftentimes I'll be able to achieve a certain detail with an extra loop by just utilizing the subsurface modifier and pulling verts. The hair is now getting attention again. I don't really like what I have, but I don't want to delete it completely. I'm going to make a duplicate and make changes on that so I don't lose this first option. So I've opted for a simple beveled shape for the hair, which I think goes better with the overall set and won't be too distracting from the shapes of the head. It's best to have a harmony of details on your model that focus the viewer's eyes on the things that are most important or took the most time. If something is detailed all over, it can be easy for the viewer to feel overwhelmed and look somewhere else or focus on something you weren't intending. Being cognizant of this will help development time and overall quality of a mesh or scene. After getting an overall shape down for the hair and sizing the night with the other pieces, I decided to tone down the height of the hair, again trying to tone down the distractions. Something to point out is how much more I need to select, rotate, and align when making large adjustments at this stage. Instead of just selecting with a click and moving, I have to select multiple verts either with C or B and then translate, possibly needing to then rotate the group to keep vert alignment clean. It's not a huge problem, but definitely could have been easier in the beginning stages. I'm turning on proportional editing here so I can manipulate a few of the tail end verts all at once. Normally, I would grab both sides and scale on the X, but because I'm using the mirror modifier, I can't select the other side. I'll need to translate instead. I then apply the mirror so I can connect verts and create a symmetry line at the end, and then eventually delete a side to bring the mirror back. So with that, we start to conclude the second video of the low and high poly workflow. Check out the third and final part of the series where I use the night high poly to make a low poly version. And let us know what you thought of part two in the comments below. Hit that like and subscribe if you want more helpful videos like this from the TimefireVR team.